El día de hoy tenemos a un amigo de mucho tiempo ya, Mostida, que va a entrar aquí. Le vamos a enseñar español porque no sabe nada. No sabe nada de español. Es gringo, gringo. Así que nosotros vamos a hacernos responsables de hacerlo aprender un poco de español. Español importante, español que lo vaya a ayudar. Herrero Rocher. Usted cierre los oídos y cierre los ojos. Digo, tápese los oídos y cierre los ojos. ¿Escuchaste de la puna del lago Saste anoche? ¿What? ¿Me alburió? No sabe nada de español. ¿Cuánto español sabes?
Buenos días, por favor.
Ok, at least you can say good morning and please.
Chili con queso.
Chile con queso, ok.
Chile con queso.
Femboy. No, no es un femboy. He's not a femboy. His avatar is a female. Su avatar es mujer. No, he's not a furry. No, no.
What the hell? Y'all are like going crazy immediately.
Introduce yourself so that way they don't think that you're a femboy or a furry.
Hello, I'm Ghost Data. I'm not a furry, but I like the art. I am not a femboy, unfortunately for y'all, but I do music for my job. I like sushi and not long walks on the beach. I like being at home and being in front of my computer.
Hace música de tiempo completo, así que eso es su trabajo. Okay, so you already see here that we have a word. How would you pronounce that? Like, you want to give it a try?
What's the first word?
It starts with a P.
Oh. Is it pen-po?
Yes.
Okay, pen-po?
Yeah, pen.
Does that mean dumb?
Yes. So you could say, estás bien p***o.
Estás
bien.
Bien.
Pen-po.
Estás bien pen-po.
Yes.
How would I say it in like a playful mood?
You would say it, estás bien pinto.
Estás bien pinto.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Que pinto.
Que pendejo.
Yeah, que.
Que pinto.
If you're on a serious note, like you really want to say someone's like a fuck dumb, que alguien la está cagando, just say, que pinto.
Que pinto. Okay. How would you say the chat is being dumb at?
Están pendejos chat.
Están pendejos chat.
Okay, so next word, I have this one. It's an F. It starts with an F.
Is fresa?
Yes, that is correct. Fresa, yes.
Fresa.
What do you think that means?
Fresa, frozen.
No, no significa congelado. No, it does not mean congelado. It means strawberry. Significa strawberry.
Strawberry?
Yes, significa strawberry. Pero lo puedes usar en diferente contexto, que significa chico rico o niña rica, which means rich and preppy. Obviously, if you say, man, I really want some fresa. Se me antojó una fresa, which can actually mean two things. Se me antojó una fresa.
Is it a bad word?
Good. It could be a good word and a bad word. It could be a good word meaning I want a fresa. Fresa means I want a strawberry, or it can mean I want a fresa. You mean you want someone that's rich and preppy?
What the?
It's a type of person in Latin America that's like at a higher status.
Ghost, eres fresa? Someone just said that in chat.
Eres fresa, yeah, means you're rich.
Eres fresa.
Eres fresa. Eres una fresa.
Esa fresa.
But if you say it like that, it sounds like you. It sounds like one, or you're really hungry, or two, you really want a rich and preppy girl.
Esta fresa. Is that bad?
No, it just sounds weird. Condesa speaks like a fresa. No es cierto. That's false. Eso es falso. Yo no sueno como una fresa. Ni él te la creó. No es cierto. Se está riendo con ustedes. Oh, you could say, me gustan.
Me gustan.
Las. Góticas.
Góticas.
Culonas.
Las góticas culonas.
It means I love big booty goth chicks.
Wait. Can you, I gotta write that one down. Hold on. Okay. Me gustan las góticas culonas. Me gustan las góticas culonas.
Yes! How would you say it? It starts with an M.
Mama huevo.
It's mama huevo.
Mama huevo.
Yes.
Mama huevo. Mama huevo. I don't know. Mama waves.
Olas de mamá. Mama huevo means two things, which can mean sucker.
Wow.
But we use it in a context that is means stupid or idiot.
Mama huevo.
Sí, like, hey, mama huevo.
Hey, mama huevo. Yo lamer huevos mean.
You lick balls. un lame huevos.
Un lame huevos.
Yeah, un lame huevos.
Lick balls.
You could use it amongst your friends. Lo puedes usar con tus amigos, como diciendo, hey, mama huevo, ¿cómo estás? O, ¿qué pasa, mama huevo?
Mama huevo.
¿Qué pasó, mama huevo?
¿Qué pasó, mama huevo? Yo, oro hambra, ¿qué pasó, ¿Qué, mama huevo?
¿Qué hubo, mama huevo?
¿Qué hubo, mama huevo? I can't go to my favorite taco truck and be like, hey, yo, mama huevo.
No! 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 Or you could use it in a bad context too. What's a character in League of Legends?
Elise.
Esa Elise es un mama huevo.
Elise es un mama huevo. No, no, Elise. Elise would be me gustan las góticas chulonas.
No.
She is. She's a big spider lady.
Oh my God. You're learning. I'm proud.
Yeah, I'm learning.
It's okay. It's the one that starts with W E Y and then G U E Y.
Way.
Yeah, it's two different ways of writing it, but it means the same thing. Yeah, way.
Way. Like hey, way. Like hey, you.
Yeah. That's definitely what it means, dude.
Hey, dude.
Yeah, it's hey, way. ¿Cómo estás? Hey, way.
Hey, way. Mama huevos.
Now we know way means dude, but it can also mean you're dumb.
Really?
Yes. You could say estás bien way means you're really dumb.
Estás bien way?
Yeah, estás bien way.
Estás bien way.
Yeah. If you're worried about your friend, estás preocupado por tu amigo, estás bien way?
Estás bien way?
Which means, are you okay, man?
Estás bien way?
Yeah, exactly. Okay, let's go.
Le gusta mucho el chile. Does that mean I love chile very much?
Yes and no. There's two contexts. You could say me gusta mucho el chile to mean I love hot, spicy. But
le gusta mucho el chile.
If you say that in front of people in Latin America, they're going to be like, hey, yo, because it can also mean I love.
Why does everything mean penis in Spanish?
I don't know, bro. I don't know. No sé por qué todo tiene que ver con penis, pero pasa.
What does muy sexo mean?
¿Qué? Mucho sexo sería.
Mucho sexo, por favor. Sexo, por favor.
Okay, next word.
Que ching.
Yes. Oh, perfect.
Que ching.
Que ching. Significa badass, cool.
So I could say Arnold Schwarzenegger, que ching.
Arnold Schwarzenegger es ching.
Es ching.
Yeah. You could say Lightning McQueen, que ching.
Lightning McQueen, que ching.
Next, we have C-A-B-R-O-N.
Cabron.
Yes, perfect. What do you think it means?
I hear people call each other, hey, cabrón. Like, hey, cabrón. Hey, fucker. Hey,
yes. It could be two things. It could be motherfucker or it could be bad.
Someone said bastard.
Bastard.
No, that's bastardo. Yeah.
Yeah, culo means butt. So you could just say tremendo culo.
Tremendo culo. Big booty.
Yeah. Hey, that means that's a big booty.
Me gustan las tremendo góticas culonas.
You could say, me gustan las góticas con tremendo culo.
Me gustan las góticas con tremendo culonas. Am I doing it right?
You're doing great.
Yeah, I'm learning.
It's cool because culonas means multiple. Like, there's more than one. I'm trying to say singular. Like, they're singular.
But I want all of them. You mucho can... gracias, por favor.
We're going to the next word.
Oh, just that? That's it? Neta?
Yeah.
Neta. I have no idea.
It means, for real? Really?
Really?
Yeah. Neta?
Neta?
Yes. Alguien te está echando el chisme. You just say, neta? Like, for
neta,
real?
Neta?
Yeah.
How
neta,
do you say, holy shit, really?
The right second way you could say it is a la madre neta.
A la madre neta?
Yeah.
A la madre neta, wey.
That's good, that's good.
A la madre neta, me gusta la gótica con tremendo culón.
It's great. We understand your needs. Next word, it's N-O-M-A-M-E-S.
No mames?
Yes.
Hey, no mames. I have no idea. Like, no way. Is it you're kidding?
Yes, it means you're kidding.
Really?
Yeah, it means you're kidding.
No mames.
The direct translation of that word means don't suck dick. But the way that we use it, it means you're kidding? No way. Or you're messing with me. Kind of thing. Like,
no mames?
No mames.
A la madre neta.
P-I-C-O. Pico.
Pico. Pico de gallo.
There's two meanings to this word. The direct translation would be pickaxe, but...
So for like, if I'm in Minecraft, I'd be like, I'm looking for pico.
Sí, estoy buscando un pico.
Estoy buscando el pico.
But, depending on who you're around, pico also means...
Pico. How many words mean pico?
A lot of words. A pico, you could say pito, you could say... You could say pico.
What gallo mean?
De gallo means rooster. Pico?
Rooster.
No!
A la madre neta?
The context of... It's a Chilean context. So it's someone from... Oh. If you say it in front of someone that's from Chile, they'll understand it as...
Hey, condesa, por favor, pico. Pico, por favor.
You could say, si tiene pito, es más rico. Si tiene pito.
Si tiene pito.
Es más rico.
Es más rico.
Yes.
What did I just say?
It means if it has a piss, it's even yummier.
Si tiene pito, es más rico. Si tiene pito, es más rico. A la madre neta.
Vamos a usar el ejemplo de teta.
Teta.
Yeah, which means boob.
Tetita.
Si quieres ser una boobie chiquita, es tetita. Si quieres ser una buba grandota, tetota.
Tetota. Tetas.
O tetitas. Tetotas.
Tetotas. Oye, tetotas, eh.
Oh, somebody said, me gustan las góticas culonas con tetotas.
Me gustan las góticas culonas con tetas. Me gustas las góticas culonas con tetosa. Tetos. Tetotas.
Se mamó. Now you have your priorities straight. Ya tienes tus prioridades. Puedes ir allá en el mundo a aprender todo lo que... O poner tu español a prueba. You can go out in the world and put your Spanish to the test.
Yay, I will get slapped so fast.
They played a sound saying, oh, me vengo. It means, oh, I'm coming.
Oh, me vengo. Oh, me vengo.
No. No, no le enseñen eso.
Estoy exitoso.
Lo soltamos ya para que vaya al mundo y use su español para las minitas.
Me gustan las córticas culonas con tetotas. Con respeto. Excitado. Con respeto. See you next
time.
I have one more thing to say before I go, though.
Okay. Cerveza Crisa.